Good after morning, folks. Mike Wells, Your World Explorer. Right now we're going to go ahead and take a look at our squash plants and the three separate control groups where we're trying to fight the root knot nematode or root boring nematode. So right here, what we're looking at is a control setup where we've inoculated the soil with beneficial bacteria. And as you can see, the squash plants are in their infancy. So at this juncture, we can't really tell whether or not they are the beneficial bacteria are keeping the root knot nematodes away. Now over here, we've used juglone control in the soil. Basically, that's black walnut hull powder. And by the way, I'm going to be using gamma cyhalothrin. That's the insecticide. It basically it comes from flowers naturally. However, in its synthetic form, it basically is almost identical to the stuff that is, you know, made naturally from the flowers. So anyhow, that'll be used to keep the squash bugs away, to keep the vine borers away, and to also keep away the loopworms, because those eggs are laid under the leaves and on the stems of the leaves. And when you use the gamma cyhalothrin, it causes the eggs to crack, and then they never hatch. So here we are with the black walnut hull powder in the soil, and it looks like this control is too young to really definitively tell whether or not that's working. So let's move over to the third control. Now this control is interesting because we used earthworm castings in the soil, and there really are no examples to follow right now out of Florida as to whether or not earthworm castings work in this sandy, really trashy soil that everybody has been blessed with. So with this control, you can see that the plants are a lot more vibrant than the other two controls that you had just witnessed. I'm not sure what would keep the root knot nematodes away in regard to the earthworm castings, but if it works, well, that's going to be something that we use going forward for sure. And if you can get a secondary benefit by using the earthworm castings, such as like a fertilizing benefit, then that might be something that we entertain going forward, because these definitely look like they're a lot more fertile than the other two examples. Now I'm gonna throw a fourth example in here that is just straight organic. Here's our fourth example. We did the lasagna layering in the soil and did nothing else. So what we're looking at is we started from here all the way over to there with squash plants, and we can tell that the root knot nematode is having its way with these squash plants. We also were getting attacked by the loopworm, and so what we did was we took the gamma cyhalothrin and sprayed the leaves to try and combat that loopworm, and it's been working. I've been picking loopworms off as well, but let's go ahead and pull one of these guys up. Yeah, there is no question as to whether or not the root knot nematode is able to make its way into these squash plants. So at this juncture, it's looking like the organic methodology either isn't strong enough, organic enough, or it just doesn't work altogether. So going forward, we might go ahead and replant this patch to have a more resistant means for keeping these group knot nematodes at bay. Folks, thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe as it helps the channel grow, and stay tuned as we'll keep you updated on the progress of these root knot nematode battles. Have a great day.